what the nut is up. You know, it's been a very long time. I'm aware of that. I'm aware of that, you know what I mean? But today, you know, I'm not going to do too long of like an intro or anything like that. We'll do like a life update video sometime down the line, but today we're just going to do a full raw workout video. Not really any fancy edits, just taking you guys through like a full in-depth glute day, a little bit of hamstrings as well. I just want to get back to showing you guys my workouts, so that's what we're going to do today. I just got back from a trip from Miami literally 6 hours ago, but we got to get back on the ball because, you know, I ate a little bit off plan and stuff, which is fine because my coach told me that it was fine. So I got to enjoy life a little bit, but yeah, I'm ready to get back on top of things. So let's go to the gym, shall we? Oh, come on. You gotta say hi to the vlog. Oh, not the candy. Oh, the candy's crazy. You got your sister's whip or what? Huh? You got your sister's whip or what?
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Let me find out you're going 90 miles an hour in that thing. Crazy. Oh, no, not the hat. Oh, wait, let me turn up the brightness. Hey, this baby right here, this baby been through it. Has been through it. Oh, no, no, no. That's like 20 shades off right there. That's terrible, actually. We have glutes. I always train them with Olivia because she likes her little thrusties. We got a little, what's this called? My intra. It's just cranberry juice and intra workout from Raw. We got all the Rice Krispies on deck over here. There you go. I only have the small ones. But yeah, I'm gonna film this. Like I said, this is just gonna be like a raw workout, so no, I'll put some music over some of the clips, but I'm gonna try to keep these mics on most of the time. Let's go. All right, so we're just gonna warm up with like a little bit of, can you guys even see me? Probably not. We're gonna warm up with a little bit of walking just cause, you know, we're a little stiff from Miami and whatnot. I'm just gonna do like 5 minutes. Why it gotta be so loud, huh? Oh, let me tell you, I got the little, those little muffins.
Yeah.
From Hummus Fit or whatever. Did I tell you about those? Oh, I saw, that's the meal prep?
Yeah.
Oh, the little muffins? Oh, those may be dangerous right
really?
There. They're like protein muffins, but they taste like, they just taste like normal muffins. And there's like this pumpkin cheesecake one. Oh, I took one bite and said, oh, let me put that away. We're already too thick. Oh, no. Oh no, that baby was real good though. Let me tell you something. Damn, I did get all bit up with bug bites, huh? I think it's my, it's cause outside of my, they're just like, oh, they, no, hey, no, the cheeks is about to fall out of these ones, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, come on, come on, come on. All right, so hopefully you can hear me and see me okay. If not, sorry. So first things first, we're doing Bulgarians on the pendulum squat machine. So not like the normal pendulum where you go like this. You can see Liv right here. So honestly, I haven't done it this way in a long time, but this is one of my favorite ways to do it because the way that this machine is set up, it kind of drops down almost at a like, it comes like this, right? So if I'm facing this way, it kind of comes like this, which is perfect because where the range of motion is on a Bulgarian, it's right in the middle. So it almost kind of forces your hips to go back. That probably made no sense, but you guys will get what I'm saying right now. I think probably weighs around like 60 pounds on its own. So we're not doing any weight because this is the first exercise. And we're not going like full exertion. We're more so just trying to get the glutes warmed up. And then we'll get into going a little bit harder on the exertion scale. So we have 3 sets of 12. I already did my first set. Yeah, you can do these on like Smith machine dumbbells. I always like doing it on a machine just because I feel like it's less work for my forearms to hold onto the weights, even with wraps. And I just feel like I can focus on getting the good leg and glute contraction instead of focusing on like wobbling around, you know what I mean? I'm convinced by part of the reason my hamstrings blew up so much quicker than my glutes was because whenever I would do hip thrusts, I would legit only feel them in my hamstrings. But now, me and my coach have worked on getting my glutes to activate more when I do hip thrusts, and now I feel them a lot more, and I feel like it's definitely been helping me make some good progress. So I got 3 sets right now, ranging from 12 to 18. We're also increasing weight each set. Olivia's gonna put on a performance for you. This is her song right here. This is her song. This was her song in Miami. She was dancing on the beach. Oh, come on. You're doing something like this. Oh, that's crazy. No, that's crazy. No, come on. You gotta do the whole thing. Oh, no. Oh, wow, wow, wow. I give that one a 2 out of 10 right there. I think the beach one was a little bit better. All right, all right, all right, all right. This is our second set right here. So the goal is for each set for us to progress up weight and also keep the reps relatively high, because my coach wants me doing ranging from reps of 12 to 18. So I did, this is what I do, 16 reps on the first set. So we're gonna try to get as close to 16 as we can on the second. Those things are feeling mad heavy today for no reason. I'm embarrassing Olivia. Let me get... We got another set. Last set, last set. All right. We got RDLs. RDLs next. Same thing applies with these. As a hip thrust, so we're trying to go heavier on each set, and we have 3 sets. I feel about weak as hell today. Hard with this bulk because you lose a lot of definition, obviously. Like my quads right now, them babies got no definition. My hammies out the window. But it's cool to see how much thickness my legs have gotten. You know what I mean? We're doing Smith machine squats. A little bit more glute focus, a little bit wider stance, so not really focusing on shooting the knees forward, focusing on pushing hips back while still keeping a neutral spine. This is my second set, by the way. Actually, I need to add weight. Please hold, please hold. Yeah. Up next, we got lying hamstring curls. This prime hamstring curl, the one where it has the three different settings where you can put where you want the weight to be the heaviest, so like in the beginning, middle, or end range, so goaded. So I'm gonna warm up. I only have two sets of 15 on these, but they're like till complete failure. So we're gonna get a good warm up in on them and then get two solid sets in. Cause right now, I'm barely training hamstrings. I would say I'm very hamstring dominant. Like my quads and my glutes are very stubborn, but my hamstrings are like weeds. So in total, I only have like, I think 5 working sets a week of hamstrings. So yeah, today I have 2 of them. All right, we're moving on to our working sets. So like I said, 2 sets, I got 15 reps on these two. I have the weight heaviest in the middle range and the end, the middle and the end range. Cause I don't like when this is too heavy in the beginning. Cause I just feel like, I don't know. It makes my like hamstrings feel like it's doing more work than it is. That makes no sense actually. I feel like when it's too heavy in the beginning and too light at the end, don't fall. I'm not getting the range of motion that I really want to work. Cause I want to work like my little tie-in area, so up here, right in the beginning, right here works more like a little bit lower, and we already got a good amount of that going on, so I need to work a little bit more up at the top. Oh, that baby's feeling real heavy. Yeah. No. That shit is awful. Up next. And if you're asking yourself, Riley, this is a really long workout. I know. It's a very high volume workout, but my volume for legs right now is combined to 2 days a week. So I'm not hitting legs 3 times a week right now. So on the days that I do have legs, it is a lot of volume. But so I have high stance, high, and toes wide leg press. So a little bit of adductors and glutes. My adductors also grow very quickly, so I don't touch on those too often. But this leg press right here is fire. Hopefully you guys can kind of see it, but it kind of comes at like, it's not just a horizontal, it kind of almost swoops down and up, so it really gets a good stretch on the glutes. I personally really like it. Hey Liv, can you put a 5 or a 10 on top?
nonsense. See, I feel like this kind of stuff is like, it's boring for me because I do the same workouts every week, but I know you guys want to see it. You guys want to see some more, you know, I gotta do the good old YouTube outro here. Like, leave a comment, subscribe for more. No, but for real, let me know in the comments if you guys want to see more. I'll leave my links on my other socials down below. Yeah, I'll see you guys on the next one. Hopefully.
Peace!